In this illustration, we'll discuss about a capacitor with tilted plate. Here, the figure shows a capacitor with one plate slightly tilted by a very small angle theta to the other plate, and we are required to find the capacitance of this capacitor. Now, in this solution, here we can see, as the parameter separation between the plate is varying along the length of plate, we need to use the concept of variation of parameters. So, we need to consider an elemental capacitance in between the two plates, for which here, say at a distance x from one side, we consider a capacitor of width dx. And the plates, upper and lower plates, can be taken as the capacitance, upper and lower plates of this capacitor, of which the capacitance we can take as dc. So here, if we write the capacitance of elemental capacitor is, this we can write as dc, which is epsilon naught A by d, and the area of the plates can be taken as dx multiplied by b, where b is the width of the plate, as the plate area is lb. So this epsilon naught b dx is the plate area divided by the separation between the plates. So this d and this additional separation, as if this is x, this can be taken as x tan theta. So here we can write it as d plus x tan theta, and as theta is small, we can write it x theta. So here we can write for a small theta, tan theta is approximately equal to theta. Now all such capacitors are connected in parallel across these two plates. As the upper plates are connected, lower are connected, they'll always be at same potential, and all such DCs can be considered in parallel. So here we can write capacitance of this capacitor is, the C can be written as integration of DC, which is integration of epsilon naught B dx by d plus x theta, and that will be integrated for x within limits from 0 to L. So here, as we are given that theta is very small, we can take epsilon naught b by d common out to the sign of integration, this 0 to L, and d plus x theta will be 1 plus x theta by d. So it will be 1 plus x theta by d to power minus 1 and dx. So this can be further written as epsilon naught b by d integration of 1 minus x theta by d multiplied by dx limits from 0 to L. So if we further integrate it, this will give us epsilon naught b by d. It is integrated as x minus theta by d multiplied by x square by 2. We apply limits from 0 to L. So this will be epsilon naught b by d multiplied by L minus L square theta by 2d, which after simplification give us epsilon naught BL can be taken as area of the plates by D multiplied by 1 minus L theta by 2D. That will be the final result of this problem.